Hey guys, we got both the 350s here, and we're going to be talking about resetting the ECUs on these things. Now both of today's cars, we have mine and Trevor's here, and they're both very lightly modified vehicles, just bolt-ons. Now my car has pretty much full exhaust, minus the factory manifolds, they're still on there. But for test purposes, we have Burke resonated test pipes, Megan Racing Y-pipe, and also a cat-back exhaust. While Trevor's has the muffler delete, and it has the Motordyne plenum spacer. Both of them have actually had, after having mods done, have tripped check engine lights. The Motordyne spacer did trip the engine light right away, while mine had the engine code P2A00, and they both seem to need the ECU reset to learn all their parameters again. Now I'm going to say this right away, I am no Nissan technician, and I've been researching a lot about ECUs and parameters because I had the check engine light. So this is just based on what we found. So the nice thing is we have kind of a constant here is we have two 2006 Nissan 350Zs, which both are right around anywhere between 60,000 to 70,000 miles. So they're very similar cars in terms of wear and how they're put together because they're both manual transmissions and they both have the rev-up motor. Now with my particular car with the P2A00 engine code, what I found was a lot of people, what the computer says is bank one, sensor one, the sensor is not in a particular range, it's not seeing what it needs to see. Now what I've seen in the forums is everyone or the shops tend to say, oh, it's a bad sensor. What they're not using the diagnostic tool is they're trying to, what they're not realizing is, well, what was the last thing done to the car? Now what I had on my car I did was, if you guys saw the last video, I put in an oil catch can. I actually had a vacuum leak at the oil catch can, a vacuum leak that I could not hear. What I had to do was I had to go into the live data feed and I had to look at my fuel trims to actually see what was going on. Now to do our live data feed, we're going to be using Grady's Infometer Touch that I had built in, or that I built into the car. It basically just plugs in, you have to give accessory ignition, and then I built this little bezel to make it look like it's part of the car. We can go over that in another video. Now most of you don't have to do something like this, you just have to get a scan tool. You can find these pretty easily at, you know, online, or a lot of even car shops will sell stuff like this, and they're not very expensive, but you need something that can do live data logging, or at least look at live data feeds. That way you can actually see what's going on. Because what I noticed was the car was richening up quite a bit on its short-term fuel trims and on the long-term, and what that led me to believe is because I knew what I recently did the vehicle was, we were letting in more air that wasn't passing through the mass airflow, and the mass airflow is freaking out seeing that there's lower air, and it was compensating and it was driving a lot of fuel into the vehicle. Like I was off by like a full 10%, and you know, I'm trying to research more. I don't actually know what the car's parameters need to see all the time. I'm hoping some other people can chime in here and probably and hopefully provide some links in the comments, if you guys could, to show what these Nissan 350s need to see. That way people, when they do, like, it's nice to see this information, but if you don't know where your baseline's supposed to be, it's kind of useless. Now we know that we need to be like 14.7 on the ratio, or on your O2s, like right now it's just, until it warms up, it just stays there, but 0.45 is perfect. But these cars, people have said, you know, can run 0.6 volts to 0.7, that's actually normal. That's what I've been noticing with this vehicle driving. So I would love for you guys to chime in on the parameters of these vehicles and help explain more. But it seems that when these vehicles, once it's learned its parameters, it kind of sticks to them. So for the example, like Trevor's car over there, when we did the MREV, we're getting a lot more air into that intake plenum, and the computer got unhappy. Did an ECU reset, relearned all the new parameters, it was happy. Same thing with this car, it seems, that with the test pipes on, it needed the ECU reset to learn its new parameters, and now it seems to be happy again. So yeah, this was the piece that I installed, and I'm either thinking it was the elbow wasn't on tight enough, or there wasn't a thread sealant, or the coupler down low. You know, it can happen when these things are put together. It's put together by hand, or it could have been me because it was most likely me because I was readjusting it, honestly, and it was creating a vacuum leak. But you guys saw in the video, I tested it and it was listening for a vacuum leak, and didn't hear anything. And I drove the car around for a week, and then I induced the problem, and I was throwing off that code. And upon further research of that code, people have said that that code would be related to vacuum leak or exhaust leak. Well, given that the car's had the exhaust on it for the past 6 months, driven as much as I could and never throwing the code, and then I put that guy in and then I got the code, kind of have to think it's more of a vacuum leak. The problem I was doing was I was just clearing the code, and the vehicle seemed to have been storing the code and using it as a diagnostic parameter, and thus reintroducing the code after a day because I actually still had a leak. And when I was checking my parameters, the car was, fuel trim was dumping a lot of fuel in. Okay, then what I did was, okay, that's doing that. I resealed the elbow and the drain plug, ran the motor again, checked my fuel trims. I dropped by 10% just by doing that alone. So that would tell me that I had a vacuum leak because, you know, the computer compensated right away after changing two little things. But the problem that I was having was because of the stored code, it just kept coming back. Now, since the ECU reset, I've driven it quite a bit now. It hasn't come back. It seems that that was the culprit. So what I have here is a printed off instructions to be found on the internet that we find work the easiest. It does clear the engine light and it seems to reset the ECU. And you don't have to do that weird timing thing. I've seen a lot of instructions. People are so gung-ho on the timing, and the timing's actually kind of off where they have such a hard time doing it. Doing it this way, we found you can really slow it down, follow the instructions. A lot of you are going to get done the first time. Some of you might take, you know, two or three times, but it's a lot easier. What else I've done is I have printed this off, and I actually keep a copy of my car just in case. This is the downside when you run a modified car, is you might have to deal with things like this. So what I would do is, the easiest way to do this, honestly, is either pause the video and I'll have a caption with the instructions written down, or if you scroll down and look in the description, I will put the instructions there again. That is the easiest way to actually accomplish this. But I'm going to do this on video to help show you guys, kind of get an idea what this should look like. Okay, the first thing we do is we're gonna turn the ignition on. Now you're gonna count to three. One Mississippi, two Mississippi, three Mississippi. Now I'm gonna press on the accelerator pedal five times. One, two, three, four, five. After the five times, you're gonna let go right away and you're gonna count to 10, not seven. A lot of the instructions say seven. So you go one Mississippi, two Mississippi, go all the way to 10. After that, you're gonna fully press the pedal. Now you're gonna count to 12 seconds. One Mississippi, two Mississippi. We're gonna count all the way up to 12, and then we're gonna release the pedal. During this, the S.E.S. light should start blinking. Now while you see it blinking, when you hit 12 seconds, release the gas pedal and count to 10. Okay, at this point you see it blinking, you've counted to 12 seconds, now you're going to release. Now you're going to count again to 10 seconds. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi. You're going to go all the way to 10 seconds. After 10, you're going to hit the pedal down again. And then you're going to count to 10 seconds right after you hit it. So you go 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi. After that, you're going to release. Okay, let's try doing this in a full sequence now. Now the last step is you shut off the ignition and turn the engine back on. If you've performed the steps correctly, the engine light will turn off. Now at this point, what I would prepare to do is I would drive the vehicle. There are some people that have said that there's a shop out there that said when they do things like this, when they change the parameters of the vehicle, they recommend driving for 100 miles nonstop. I cannot confirm or deny this. I've tried it. Like, I did the reset and I drove all the way from Abbotsford to the top of Seymour Mountain on the number one. I figured, you know, I was out doing nothing, I might as well just go out for a nice drive. So it has worked for my car, and it makes sense because the car is in a relearn. It's in a relearn mode, so you might as well put it through the ringer. So I put it through highway driving, a little bit city highway driving, and a mountain road run all in one shot. Now, not all of you have that kind of environment, so just, you know, drive it around on the highway for an hour and let that vehicle learn all its new parameters. Well guys, hopefully that engine reset procedure works for you. Now remember, if there actually is something wrong with your vehicle, the check engine light is going to come back on. You have to get that addressed. This is gonna be for people that have put on some mods and are changing the parameters of the vehicle and need to relearn it. Just don't keep resetting the engine light every time you feel like it. Address the problem if there actually is one, because you might damage the vehicle. Another reason why you guys might want to do the ECU reset is because if on some vehicles, I'm not sure if it's affecting this one, but I have a feeling it was, that if there's an engine code and it gets stored and you just clear the light with the scan tool like I showed earlier, the computer might actually start using that stored code as a way for checking for parameters for the diagnostics. So by clearing the ECU completely of its memory and it just basing it on what it sees on the initial relearn, that might help you guys get rid of reoccurring engine lights all the time. To see what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Instagram and Facebook, AnthonyJ350, and also check out my website at www.gofasthavefun.ca.